stuck. They wanted all these things in their life, but they were stuck and they didn't know how to move forward. I want a relationship. I want to have a better job. I want more money to do things with. I want to have a better home. I want to have a better relationship with my kids. But for some reason, they were stuck. And as I prayed with each one of them, I realized, wow, there's a common ground here. Wow, I wonder what other singles were stuck. Now, I'm sure married people are too, but we don't care about them so much. I mean, there's some in here that I care about, but you know, everybody gets stuck. The word is the same for everybody. You know that, right? But the cool thing about bringing us all together is that most everyone in here is not married in some aspect or not. And so we have that commonality of knowing there's something similar between me and this other person. So when I talk about things that keep me stuck, some of it might relate to our singleness. And not everybody wants to be single. Not everybody's happy where they're single. Not everybody's joyful in their singleness. And some of you have cried out for years and asking, God, why? Why am I still here? Not here, you know, living. Although some of you might be asking that too. But some of you are like, Lord, this wasn't the way it's supposed to be. I didn't expect it. I had all these plans. I didn't have my house, have my kids' names picked out. For you younger ones, well, some of us older too. And some of you are like, my marriage was supposed to last forever, and it didn't last. And we said, I knew it was wonderful. We had all of our kids, and we had grandkids, and then it ended. And now what am I supposed to do? And then in my wonderful hopes, we're telling me to lose her husband a year ago. That wasn't the plan. You know, but unless you die when your spouse dies, you're going to be single. I don't think a lot of married people realize that. Now, what does that word mean? Does it mean that you're worthless? Does it mean you're pathetic? Does it mean that nobody wants you? Well, Jesus was single. Did that apply to him? They don't know the top of that, Jesus being single. Yeah, you ever heard a sermon? Yeah, it's really the top sermons right now at Lifeway. Ooh, top 10 sermons. Jesus was single, number one. No. The reason none of your pastors preach of Jesus being single is because I believe in their minds that singleness is not a good thing. That God can't use you where you are until he moves you. For a large percentage of us, due to a broken world, we're not going to be married. So what are you doing where you are until God changes that course? There's nothing wrong with wanting to be married. There's nothing wrong with wanting that part of your heart to have someone to have that intimacy with and that companion with. This is the way God designed us. But for some of us, God is trying to get your attention in a different direction. You just keep going, And he's not, excuse me. Amen?
Amen.